before you even reach success. That is a huge thing to be able to obtain, is significance before your successes. We are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared us in advance for us to do. God has already prepared good works in advance for you to be able to do, but you must keep your eye focused on the highest point. Next slide. The search for a mate hits everyone's life at some part. Now, some people may realize when they get to that point, they don't want a mate, which is, that's still a coming to a conclusion. But it is not all there is to life. A mate is not the end of utopia. Or even the most important part of your life is not your mate. It is only one of the items we have to juggle every day and only part of the whole. The strangest thing about happiness are those who seek happiness that they rarely find it. That's the strangest thing I find about happiness, is the ones who are seeking happiness rarely find happiness. They are always complaining. You know, I'm unhappy. I'm cheated out of this. If I only had that, I'd be happy. You hear them complain. If I only had a car, I'd be happy. They get a car, they're still not happy. If I only had a condominium, I'd be happy. They work themselves to death. They get a condominium. The condominium's not what they thought it would be. If I only had a higher career level, I'd be happy. They work like a dog. They scratch. They fight. They even backbite. They climb the ladder, wounded and dying, and they get up to the next ring in the ladder, only to find out that the ladder really isn't that high up after all. And they keep looking for happiness, and they rarely find it. Why? The next slide. Happiness is the byproduct of something else, and only a sovereign God who has planned a good work for us can guide us with his eye to that something else. If you are looking for happiness, it will always take something else. The only way to get true happiness is to look into God's eye, and he will guide you to whatever that something else is that you think you're looking for that you can never find. Look at the next slide. Happiness versus joy. You know that you are looking for happiness if it's always elusive to you. You can't find it. You're always discontent. You can't find it. You know, it's got to be just right around the corner, and if I just keep going and I get around that corner, I know it's going to be there. I will do this, this, and this, and I will get it. Those who seek it rarely find it. Happiness is dependent on circumstances. If you're happy 1 minute and then when something changes and the stock market crashes and you lose a huge investment, then all of a sudden you're not happy anymore. You're very upset. You're suicidal. You jump out a window. When the stock markets crashed in the U.S., people jumped out of buildings because their happiness was based on a monetary circumstance. Happiness rises and falls according to what happens around us. If your happiness was built on an investment maybe that you made in Indonesia and the tsunami comes and wipes out a whole section of land that you just built a hotel on, wow, then your happiness is gone and you're very depressed. We try to change our circumstances so we'll be happy. I'll relocate. I'm not happy in Singapore. I cannot stand the government. I can't stand the way the school system is. I can't stand the pressures they put on my family. I can't stand. I'll relocate to Australia. And then you get to Australia and you can't stand the people there. Wow, these people are so laid back. They don't care about nothing. They have no ambition. Oops, sorry. Just throwing that one out by, okay, sorry. No inference to your nation. So you go there and you will find something for sure. Happiness is based on temporary things. Let's go to joy. Next slide. This is what you really want. Joy is based on our relationship with the Lord. And joy can be consistent. Happiness cannot. How do I know that? Look in Acts 16, 19 through 40. Paul and Silas were cruelly beaten at Philippi. They were put in the jail under maximum security. And even that they've been beaten and they're in maximum security, they still put them in chains and lock them up and they're in maximum security. He's like, where are they going, people? I don't think you have to lock them up and be, if you beat them, they have, they're totally incapable of getting up and moving. You've beaten them, and you put them in maximum security. But you are so bad, now you're going to put them under lock and key, and they got them all bound up. And their happiness was just in situations, circumstances. Man, I work for God. They beat me up. I give my life for Him, and I get thrown in maximum security. And then I'm treated as the worst prisoner of the worst. They lock me up in bonds in maximum security. Their happiness was not based on circumstances. Why? Because they had joy. How do I know they had joy? Because it says in the prison they worshiped God and sang a song. How many times have you been able to sing a song when you're not happy? When you don't have, when you're not having happiness, you don't have true joy, do you sing? Well, I can just watch some of you when you come in. Had a lousy day, man. My teacher at school was so mean. My friend, no friend, me. You know, you can see it. Your circumstance is lousy. So there is no joy because everything is based on happiness. You're doing very temporal with situations. But we're seeing two people here who were able to worship, but not only worship. It said that in the midst of the prisoners, where they were considered the worst of the worst, in the middle of all of that circumstances, they are locked up and beaten and left for dead, and they sit there locked up and start worshiping and singing some more. They walk in and they have the joy of the Lord. This is the day. Woo! I just got beat. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Woo! I feel good. How do you feel good in that? It's because they don't have happiness. They have joy. And what happened because they had joy? Because they had joy, the whole prison was affected. And as it was shaken and everything came apart and they were free to go, instead of running out the door for freedom, they ran into the innermost parts of the prison, and everybody was so affected by their joy that instead of them running out when they could be free, they ran and followed him into the innermost parts of the prison. And when the jailer was ready to kill himself, he said, don't kill yourself. I know where they're all at. They're in there in the innermost part. Their joy had made significance. You cannot base your hope on happiness. You can only do that with a relationship with Jesus Christ, that no matter what happens, you can still have joy. Because the Lord says, the joy of the Lord is my strength. That's where your strength comes from. Next slide. That is why we can consider it pure joy, the scripture says, when we face trials of many kinds. When you have a trial, you can say, this is joy. Why? Because the Lord is your strength. And in a bad situation, you could still have a song to sing. Instead of trying to change our circumstances, we concentrate on letting God work through our circumstances to what? God, change my circumstances. They're in the prison. Get me out of prison. I've been beaten unjustly. No. They said instead of trying to change their circumstances, they concentrated on God's working in that circumstances to change them and building godly character into their lives. God, you allowed this, so I am going to be better through this. And you are my strength. You will take me through this. And your joy will be my strength through every single step of the way. Okay, let's review it. And I want to go to a couple of, I want to give you 7 points real quick. And then we're going to get into our next chart, all right? Preparing to be God's choice. 7 things you have to do. Identify your value and identity in Christ. These I did not write out for you, but I can give them to you at another time if you'd like them. Realize our relationship with God will never change. Realize that fellowship with God is affected by sin. These are things you have to know in order to be able to progress in your relationship. If you have fellowship with God, your fellowship will be affected if you're having sin in your life. And sin takes many forms. It can be